Welcome to Oracle Marketing Cloud Help Center videos. In this video, I'll be introducing you to the new dashboards that are available in Eloqua. There are lots of dashboards available in Classic Insight, but recently, we launched our new dashboards for you to use. These dashboards provide you with an intuitive and modern look, allowing you to examine the information that is most important to you, all without opening Insight. To access the new dashboards from the My Eloqua homepage, navigate to Analytics, then click Dashboards. In this video, we'll be looking at these four dashboards. Keep your eye on the Eloqua Release Center to see when other dashboards are live. The dashboards reflect the most up-to-date information available, so it's always current. For the purposes of this demonstration, I'll be specifically focusing on the Campaign Analysis Overview dashboard. The Campaign Analysis Overview provides a comprehensive look at all campaign activity and performance. This is a good time to note that we're looking at demo data, so the numbers may not line up as expected. Over on the left side, you can see there are different filtering options. The filter for the dashboard to show the campaign activity for the last 2 weeks is selected by default, but you can change that to the last week, month, or your own custom range. We're going to stick with the standard 2-week display. You can also filter the displayed information by campaign type, product, or region. For this video, we'll stick with the campaign type. If you only want to see a selection of campaign types, you can turn them on and off using the list under the Campaign Fields heading. Now let's take a look at the reports on the dashboard. The Outbound Activity by Campaign Type report shows the total outbound activity of all active campaigns in the set date range. By hovering over each campaign type, you can see the exact value for the outbound activity. The Overall Performance by Campaign report compares the total responses with the total inbound activity. Hovering over this newsletter bubble, we can see that there are approximately 2,500 total responses, a total inbound activity of about 47,000, and a total outbound activity of nearly 180,000, as shown by the size of the bubble compared to the others. You can zoom in on a section of the chart by clicking and dragging your cursor across the desired area. To return to the default zoom, click Reset Zoom in the top right corner. Now scrolling down to the campaign activity timeline, we see that the Day tab is showing us the last 2 weeks of data. In addition to seeing the data broken down by day, we can look at it by month, by quarter, or by year. This allows you to sculpt the report to your needs. As with the overall performance chart, you can zoom in on an area by dragging over it with your cursor. You can reset your zoom at any time by clicking Reset Zoom below the date options. The two timelines display the total outbound and total inbound activity over time, respectively. You can hover over a set of data to gain more information. Each entry is broken down by campaign type. Now, you're probably interested in a succinct way of seeing activity details for each campaign. The Campaign Activity Summary provides you with activity data for each campaign shown in the dashboard. When you look at the summary, you'll see that the data is organized by the amount of inbound activity from most to least. Due to the nature of our demo data, our instance does not reflect this. To see a more detailed view of a specific campaign, you can select it from the table. Alright, let's try to avoid confusion. These three metrics keep coming up, but just what do they mean? Total inbound activity counts the total amount of inbound activity. When multiple forms of activity are performed by a single contact, all are counted towards the total. The activity by contacts not initially in the campaign, such as a forwarded email, count as well. Total outbound activity is the total amount of outbound activity that occurs. This includes multiple forms of activity directed towards a single contact. Total responses counts the number of highest priority responses that occur. Eloqua only records the highest priority responses, as determined by your organization's response rules. It is up to your organization to determine which response has the highest priority. Now back to the dashboards. Having clicked on an individual campaign in the Campaign Activity Summary, we are taken to the Individual Campaign Performance Dashboard. In this dashboard, we can see the specific details of the campaign by its individual assets. As with the Campaign Analysis Overview dashboard, you can interact with the reports in the Individual Campaign Performance Dashboard to view more detailed information, zoom in, and adjust date ranges to focus the report on the information that is most important to you. And that just about does it. we've introduced you to the campaign dashboards, so why not go check out the email dashboards to familiarize yourself with the process? The email dashboards function identically to the campaign dashboards, only with filters and data that correspond to email performance. In addition to the Eloqua Help Center, you can get a lot of great tips and tricks from the Topliners community. Thanks for watching!